Now, humans and phones, not a new relationship, but often an unhealthy one. In fact, it's likely you spend more time with your phone than any person in your life.
Don't look at me like that. And while we know we shouldn't be spending so much time on them, how can we cut ties with the most important device in our lives?
It's not you or me. It's our phones. They're our only companion within arm's reach 24/7. But just like some relationships, our phones don't always have our best interests at heart. Experts have been dialing in on the time we spend scrolling, finding 65% of us check our phone 160 times a day. And we're aimlessly scrolling the height of Mount Everest every year. Checking into cyberspace and out of reality brings problems. So is it time to hang up on our phone habit?
And here to help us better manage our relationships with our phones is Dr. Lena Weitznegger. Great to talk to you. Now, our phones help with everything from managing work to maintaining relationships. Are they really that bad for us?
No, they're actually real productivity boosters and help us to stay in contact with our family and friends. But if we lose the control over our phones, they could actually affect our productivity, our well-being and our social relationships.
How?
So, it could affect our work productivity because especially the notifications actually distract us at work, and usually it takes up to 23 minutes after the distraction to focus back on our task.
What are the signs that we're spending too much time on our phone? How do we know?
Yeah, that's a good question. So the average time people spend on their phone is around 3 hours, 15 minutes, and we usually pick up our phone 58 times. So if you're spending on your phone like 6 to 8 hours and pick up the phone like 100 or 120 times, you might reflect on your phone usage.
What practical things can we do to get control over our phones?
Yeah, so the first thing is to get to know your phone, right? How often do you pick it up and what apps do you use? Then you can actually leverage the functionalities of your phone, right? So you can schedule do not disturb, or you can also use the wind down functionalities so that your phone switches on grayscale, for example, after 10 p.m. and it only switches on the colors after 7 a.m., right? That reduces the stimuli. And what you can also do is creating physical barriers. Stop charging your phone in your bedroom. Or you can have the phone in a drawer next to your desk, for example, right? So that you don't have this immediate impulse. If you see your phone, you just want to check it quickly.
Great advice there, Dr. Lena. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.